Hello everyone, this is K. Peter. Now for today's video, we are going to be drawing a fossil fish. And the main reason why I'm going to be drawing a fossil fish is because a YouTuber by the name of Edge, E-D-G-E, he created this week, or I should say, starting from the 15th to the 21st, it's what we call Fossil Fish Week. So to participate in Fossil Fish Week, I decided to draw two prehistoric fish. Because I like animals, I like prehistoric animals, and just why not? Now the fish that I'm going to be drawing for today's video is this guy right over here. This thingamajig right over here. It's called Dunkleosteus, and in the paleo community, I'm pretty sure everybody knows what this thing is. But for my ordinary viewers out there, I'm pretty sure not a lot of people know what this fish exactly is. Now this fish lived in a time period of Earth called the Devonian, and it was a big fish. I do believe it was one of the largest fish of its time, and it was possibly the largest predatory fish of its time as well. It's a very, very unique looking fish in my opinion, and I wanted to give my two cents on how this guy would have probably looked like in real life. Now, I'm not a scientist or a paleontologist, so the paleo art that I'm going to be creating isn't 100% scientifically accurate, so please bear in mind. But, you know, just for the fun of it, I decided to draw this guy, as well as another fish that I'll be uploading in the future, but stay tuned for that. But, you know what, I'll stop talking. Let's get straight into the time-lapse video. Alright, narration portion of the time-lapse video. Now normally when I draw something, I have reference photos that I take reference for the drawing. However, in this case, Dunkleosteus is a fish that's extinct, so I really have no reference in real life. In fact, the very sad thing is that Dunkleosteus is from a group of fish called placoderms. And these placoderms are all extinct, like none of them are alive today, which is kind of a shame. So since placoderms and Dunkleosteus don't exist right now, I took reference from existing fish. In particular, I took reference from the Goliath tigerfish. Here are two photos that I mainly took reference for. So yeah, that is that. Now for the sketch of Dunkleosteus, the thing that I wanted to make sure was that I didn't want to make Dunkleosteus shrink-wrapped. What shrink-wrapping is basically making the animal look as if it doesn't have any muscle or fat behind the skin and the bones. This is actually quite a big problem because a lot of restorations of Dunkleosteus are shown to have, you know, severe cases of shrink wrapping. I didn't want to do that, yet I still wanted to have a feeling that this Dunkleosteus that I was drawing was a armored fish. So the way I did it was I basically kind of gave it armor panels, and I didn't really want to, you know, show too many lines of the skull, if that makes sense. Basically, I kind of minimize the basic outline of the skull, yet I try to give it some armor plating. I hope that totally made sense. If you couldn't understand, I'm sorry. I'm just not really good with words. After the simple sketch was done, I did line art over it. Now for paleo art, up until now, I normally had a very cute aesthetic. So typically I draw animals in a cute style, but Dunkleosteus is an animal that I really don't think that I could have drawn in a cute way. So for this paleo art Dunkleosteus that I did, I wanted to make it look menacing. I basically didn't want to make it look cute, I just kind of made it look like a Dunkleosteus. After the sketch and line art was done, now it was time for the painting process. Now, at first, when I was painting Dunkleosteus, I actually took inspiration from the Dunkleosteus from a documentary called Chased by Sea Monsters. It was a documentary that I loved as a kid, and there was a Dunkleosteus, believe it or not, in that show. And it was also a red rusty color. But after I started drawing my Dunkleosteus in a red tone, I really didn't like it. I didn't think that it was natural looking, to be honest, so that's when I decided to change the inspiration to the Goliath tigerfish. So as you guys can obviously see from the time-lapse video, my Dunkleosteus went from a red tone to a green tone, and the reason behind it was because I changed the inspiration. With that out of the way, here is the end result. Now, this is the first time that I've ever participated in a drawing event of some sort. So, first off, I would definitely like to thank Edge for creating Fossil Fish Week and giving me an opportunity to, you know, showcase my artwork to the world. Also, Edge himself makes a ton of paleontology related stuff, so if you're interested in prehistory and whatnot, definitely go check out his channel. I'll leave down in the description below. You will not be disappointed. I mean, his content is really, really good. Thank you guys all for watching the video, and thank you guys for supporting me. It really, really means a lot. If you guys like the video, leaving a like and subscribing means the world to me. And also, if you want anything for me to draw, leave down in the comments. I read all of them, and I'll pick a comment that I find the most interesting, and I'll probably draw it in a future video. So you know what? Without further ado, I'll end the video here, and I'll see you guys in the near future. Take care.